I'm struggling a bit for video ideas here. What can I make that's interesting but won't creep anyone out? Oh yeah! So I've had head lice multiple times. Head lice are extremely common among kids, but if you have them, it's the one secret you take to the grave. Little Richard over there got lice 2 years ago and no one dares go near him. He's a lost soul, wandering the playground day in, day out, in search of meaning to his little life.
I'm fine.
Do you understand this is what having head lice does to you?
There's definitely a stigma around having head lice.
There are myths that if you have them, then that means you don't wash your hair enough.
While this isn't true, there's also another myth that lice only like clean hair, which was probably made up by people that have lice to try and get rid of the other myth, which is hilarious.
But no, having lice means that you've come into contact with someone that has lice. That's it. Shocker.
Fortunately, head lice are harmless in that they don't carry any diseases, but if you catch them, then you're hardly gonna want to keep them.
So this got me thinking. Dangerous, I know. What if you get head lice and you're vegan? Can you make an exception, or are you obliged to coexist with them now? I was looking up this vital quandary and I found this gem of an article that says, "My neighbor told me she was in the practice of combing the lice and nits into the garden where they had a chance of survival." Head lice live off of human blood. They're dead, Sally. You killed them.
I had head lice a few times growing up. My poor parents became slaves to the tea tree oil remedies that would never work and then just admit defeat and cut my hair off. I don't actually remember a lot about having head lice as a kid other than a lot of combing and crying. So I asked my parents. I recorded this audio on my phone, please don't hurt me.
Sometimes when I got the big ones out, before I put them in the water, I'd squash them between my nails and they'd crunch.
Why?
Because I wanted to make sure they were dead and they didn't jump back on your head again. Or... Yeah, I think the next thing that we would have done if that hadn't worked was there was a nip comb that you could get that was supposed to electrocute them. So you'd comb it through your hair and it would zap them.
After a couple of weeks, they built little houses and roads and it's like a little city, a knit city.
Yeah.
And tunnels under your scalp. Do you remember when Lucy was tiny and I used to trick her and I used to put a teaspoon of water?
Yes.
Do you want some of the special medicine? I just go to the tap and fill a teaspoon full of water and go, like, there you go, love you, but like, yeah, I feel better now. Yeah.
Yep, that about sums up my head lice experiences when I was a kid.
So I had them as an adult too.
I was just doing my thing when one day my head starts itching real bad out of nowhere.
In my boundless wisdom, I decide, I must have dandruff.
Yep. I've never had dandruff before, but that must be what I have. The itching got so bad to the point I was using one of those spiky hairbrushes to try and get some form of relief from my torment.
Yep, dandruff. But after a week of this, it happened.
I'm in the shower, my head is driving me nuts, and in a moment of madness, I take my fingers and pinch into my hair. Yes, Lucy, that's a head louse.
How could this happen? I'd left school at this point. I was already a seasoned social recluse.
It doesn't make a lick of sense.
I'm perplexed.
To this day, I'm still not 100% sure on how they appeared, but I narrowed it down. Important. I have extremely long hair in real life, but most of the time, I tie it up. There was this one dinner that I went to a couple of weeks before all of this. I got all fancy and dressed up and I straightened my hair. My hair is also super curly, so that adds a good inch to it.
Very long.
At this dinner were also a bunch of my parents' friends, many of whom had young children. I'd give a hug and hello, smile and pretend I know who they are. All the while, the lice buddies jump ship. I was like Rapunzel, but for head lice. Oh Lucy, Lucy, let down your hair. Finally! My days of solitude are over. Come here, my darling. As soon as I knew what was happening, I knew there was no time to lose.
So, you choose war. So be it.
This would be a tough battle, so I bought many supplies. Combed my hair relentlessly, used every product they had to offer. I think the highlight of this was this one night where I sat for 2 hours with my head covered in olive oil and cling film. I feel secure with the direction my life is going right now. I had no chill. And clearly, I did my job well, because they were gone within a week.
I had won the war. but at what cost?
It's been quite a while since this happened, but I can't scratch my head anymore without getting paranoid.
Oh no, they're back.
Of course, they never are, but
it stays with you.
I never spoke of it again. Until now. Now I'm telling nearly 200,000 people. Again, I feel like I have to emphasize that this happened quite a long time ago. So if you ever meet me, don't worry, you ain't gonna catch lights from me. Probably.
But yes, hello, I am not dead yet. I know this video took an obscene amount of time to come out, but I have many reasons. Here are the relevant ones. This is my first ever video that I've made with an actual drawing tablet. With a screen. The last video was so long ago that I already don't like all the narration poses that I made, so I made a completely new rig. I work with PNG files, so that's about as fun as it sounds. I have much more behind the scenes stuff on my Patreon. YouTube is very scary right now. Quite a few of the things I was working on involved going outside, and I can't do that anymore, so I had to completely rethink my list of video ideas. But don't worry, I've come up with ones even worse. Alright, I will see you in not 4 months. Love you, bye.